Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. If you have not already done so, we suggest that you view the first video in this astronomy mini-series before watching this one. The stars appear to move around the Earth. For many years, almost everyone thought that the Earth was the center of the universe, and that everything only goes around the Earth. In the 1500s, an astronomer named Nicholas Copernicus studied the night sky and suggested that the Sun was the center of the universe, and that the Earth and everything else went around the Sun. But his observations were complicated, and few people believed his theory. Years later, an astronomer named Galileo made one of the first telescopes. In January and February of 1610, he looked at the planet Jupiter and saw an image like this. A few days later, he noticed the small dots around Jupiter had changed their positions, and over the course of several weeks, he saw something like this, which we have sped up. Galileo realized that the tiny spots around Jupiter were moons going around Jupiter. This was the first time someone had found simple evidence to show that not everything in the universe goes around the Earth. Galileo published his findings in March of 1610. These are his drawings of Jupiter, as seen on different nights. If we zoom in a bit closer, we can see Jupiter, which is the circle that the arrow is pointing at, and its moons, which we'd numbered next to the asterisk marks. On subsequent nights, the positions of the moons changed. In the 400 years since Galileo's major discovery, many scientists have studied the planets and now agree with Copernicus that the Sun is the center of the solar system, and that all the planets and their moons go around the Sun, not around the Earth. The solar system is the name we use to describe the Sun, the eight planets, and the many smaller objects that go around the Sun. Instead of the phrase "go around," astronomers use the word "orbit." So, we say that everything in the solar system orbits the Sun. Although their paths are invisible, astronomers know where each planet travels, and since they are on different paths, the planets will not hit each other. All the planets spin, most have moons, and none of them make light. The Sun is the only source of natural light in the solar system. That means whenever we see the planets or their moons, we are seeing the Sun's reflection from their side that is facing the Sun. We'll show close-up pictures of each of these in the next 8 slides. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. If you want to memorize the order of their names, a memory aid that can help is this phrase, "My very encouraging mother just sent us notes." Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Besides the Earth, the three most famous planets in the solar system are Jupiter, Saturn, and Mars. So, we'll get a little more information about these. Several countries have sent rockets to Mars, including the US, which has also landed multiple rovers there. This image of the Martian landscape was taken by a NASA rover. This rover has analyzed the soil and atmosphere on Mars to search for signs of prior life. So far, there is no sign that Mars ever had life. This is NASA's Ingenuity helicopter flying on Mars. The air is very thin on Mars, so it is hard for a helicopter to fly there. Mars is in the news more nowadays because a company called SpaceX is making the biggest rocket in world history, like this one, so it can take people to Mars one day. Jupiter is the planet we mentioned earlier whose four large moons Galileo discovered. This interactive website lets you see Jupiter's great red spot and other parts of this planet. Jupiter is the biggest planet in the solar system. Here is a close-up of the great red spot. It is wider than the Earth, and is like a hurricane that has been storming for hundreds of years. Jupiter has no land, so everything we see are like clouds. Saturn is the second largest planet in the solar system, and has a ring around it that is made of billions of pieces of frozen water, ranging from tiny pieces of ice to ice chunks that are over 3 feet across. The four planets closest to the Sun are also the smallest planets, which includes the Earth. These four planets are the only ones in the solar system that have land, so a rocket could land there. Astronomers call these planets terrestrial because they are so similar to the Earth in size and because they have land. The other four planets are much farther from the Sun, are much bigger than the terrestrial planets, and they have no land on their surface. Instead, their surface is like a very thick cloud of gas. In addition to the planets, their moons and the Sun, the solar system also contains small objects. This includes space rocks, which can be less than 1 meter across, which we call meteoroids, and space rocks that are 1 meter or more across, which we call asteroids. There are also objects larger than asteroids and smaller than planets. Like everything else in the solar system, all of these objects also orbit the Sun. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause this video if you wish to read this. The Sun is the star that is near the exact center of the solar system. Almost all of the mass in the solar system is in the Sun. For example, let's say we have about 1,000 blocks of clay and want to make a scaled-down model of the solar system. Except for 2 squares, we would have to put all of the clay towards making the Sun. Animations like this have the planets much closer to each other than if they were scaled correctly. That's so that we can see details on the planets. In reality, the planets are very far away from the Sun and from each other. This interactive website gives a better idea of the distances between the planets and lets you speed up time so you can see which ones take longer to orbit the Sun than others. Planets closest to the Sun have the shortest orbit times around the Sun. Planets farthest from the Sun take the longest to orbit the Sun. For example, Mercury orbits the Sun in less than 3 months. But Neptune takes over 160 years to orbit the Sun. The Earth takes 1 year to orbit the Sun. We define a year as the amount of time it takes for the Earth to orbit the Sun. It's the Sun's gravitational force that keeps everything orbiting the Sun. The Sun is so important to the solar system that the solar system is named after the Sun, since the word solar means sun. One way to remember that solar means sun is to think of these panels that collect light from the Sun, which we call solar panels. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause this video if you wish to read this. We'll end with a question to help us meet an NGSS learning objective. Jupiter's diameter is more than 40 times greater than our Moon. So why does Jupiter appear so much smaller than the Moon? Before we answer that, let's look at the size of the seats in these stadiums. All of the seats are the same size, but the ones farther away from us look small. This tells us that the farther an object is from us, the smaller it will look. Next, let's compare the distance from Earth to Jupiter with the distance from Earth to the Moon. When we divide these, we find that Jupiter is almost 2,000 times farther from the Earth than the Moon is. That means Jupiter will look much smaller since it's so much farther away than the Moon is. Here's one way to visualize a factor that is about 1,800. For every 1-inch block between the Moon and the Earth, there would be a block the size of the Statue of Liberty between Jupiter and the Earth. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.